Legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitche, gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald laid empty. The good ship and crew was a bone to be chewed when the gales in November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned, including some terms with a couple still firms. And they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night when the ship bells rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The wind in the wires made a tattle-tale sound, and a wave broke over the railing. Did too, but the witch of November comes stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November come slashing. Afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed ya." At 7 p.m. a main hatchway came in, he said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. Later that night when his lights went out of sight, in the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. Might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. Legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitche.